part of my practice is treating chronic venous insufficiency. And in layperson's terms, most people would think about that as varicose veins, spider veins, and also patients with swelling in their legs or tired and fatigued legs. What chronic venous insufficiency comes from is failure of valves in the veins. And if we think about veins being a series of roadways, that's an analogy I often use with my patients, bringing traffic back to a central location, that being the center of the body, chronic venous insufficiency occurs when there's congestion in those roadways from valves not working.
They do have the same genetics, and they might...
What goes wrong with chronic venous insufficiency is often a genetic problem, and it's very, very common. Nearly 70 to 80% of patients will have a family member, a first-degree relative, or an extended family member that has varicose veins or some sort of history of varicose veins.
I'm not able to walk like I used to because I walk my dogs, and my legs just feel super heavy. And so I kind of not walking as much.